How do websites detect multiple accounts using your IP address? How do websites detect proxies? These are the questions you're probably asking yourself if you're managing multiple accounts in the affiliate, e-commerce, dropshipping, crypto, or ticketing businesses. Hi, my name is Stan, and in today's video we're going to talk about how websites use your IP address to specifically identify you, and if you're running multiple accounts, what checks and tests they do to see if you're masking anything. Now, we all know what's an IP address. An IP address is kind of like a uniquely identifiable string of digits that is given to you by your internet service provider. This IP address can then be used to connect with other websites and communicate with them. This IP address can be used to track if you're managing multiple accounts and if you don't change your IP address and connect to multiple accounts from the same IP address. Websites can easily detect that and block you for running multiple accounts. There are two popular ways how you can change your IP address. The first one is using a VPN, and the second one is to use proxies. However, the main idea that you have to know when it comes to understanding how websites detect multiple accounts using IP address is what IP address they give to you. And that is very important. Generally, there are two categories of IP addresses that websites look for. They are residential IPs and data center IPs. And that is very important to understand. Essentially, data center IPs belong to data centers. These IPs are generally used to host servers, different databases, and used to host websites. Residential IPs, on the other hand, belong to internet service providers and typically used by your home or your mobile devices. Naturally, websites trust residential IPs more, simply because it is not very common that normal website visitors connect to a website from a data center IPs. Yes, it happens sometimes. It happens in situations, for example, when you connect to internet from a corporate network, then you would have a data center IPs. But if you take a look at the normal distribution of users, at the whole distribution of users, you will see that the majority of users are actually using residential IPs. There's also another type of IP which belongs to residential ones, which are mobile IPs. With mobile IPs, the situation is a bit different, because while in residential IPs can be static and can be dynamic, mobile IPs are very dynamic IP addresses. The way how mobile IPs work is that there's only a limited number of mobile IPs available to a specific amount of people. And it happens very often that multiple users at the same time can have the same mobile IP address. And in this regard, mobile IPs become these elusive IP addresses, which is very difficult for websites to block. You can learn more about how mobile IPs work in other videos. Let me show an example of these three types of different IP addresses. I have three browsers open right here, and on the first browser, I have an IP address which shows the location of which is from the Czech Republic. And as you can see, the internet service provider of this IP address is Lease Web Netherlands. If we go ahead and Google what type of company this is, then we can see that this is basically a cloud hosting. It's a hosting provider. And that's a way how websites can detect that this IP address is coming from a data center, not from a real internet service provider. The second browser I have here is a residential IP address. As you can see, this IP address starts with 51 and ends with 29. And the internet service provider, or ISP, of this IP address is Sky UK Limited. You can also go ahead and Google this. We can see that Sky UK Limited is actually a real internet service provider, so broadband and mobile packages. So they provide broadband services. Here's an example of a mobile IP address. This is a mobile IP address. And if we take a look at the internet service provider, the ISP of this IP address, then it will be O2 Online. And if we go ahead and Google what is O2 Online, we can see that, yep, it's a mobile broadband. This is the way how websites can see whether your IP address is a data center, residential, or mobile. Besides checking what type of IP address your accounts are hosted on, Websites can also take a look at your browser fingerprints and analyze whether your browser fingerprints are consistent with the information of your IP address. There are four main browser fingerprints that can reveal your location, and this type of information must be consistent with your IP address. These are Timezone, WebRTC IP address, Geolocation API, and language. And if you just mask your IP address using a proxy and you do not care about these parameters, websites can easily detect anomalies and restrict your accounts. Let's look back to the browser where I have the Czech Republic IP address. In this browser, I have only changed the IP address. I didn't care about time zone, geolocation, or WebRTC. Here's how a website could potentially detect this. As you can see, the IP address of this browser ends with 84. However, they can also utilize a so-called WebRTC leak test, and they can reveal my real IP address, which is actually in Estonia and ends with 0.21. They can then check the location of this IP address and reveal my real location. Besides checking for the real IP address through a WebRTC module, websites can also check the time zone browser fingerprint. And as you can see here, the time zone fingerprint here is Europe Tallinn, while I'm actually showing that I'm in Czech Republic. Another parameter which can reveal my real location, even if I'm using a proxy, is Geolocation API. This is basically a mechanism in browser that can show your real coordinates. We can go to Google Maps website, and if we click on show our real location, it will actually show my location in Estonia, in Tallinn, not in Czech Republic. It used the Geolocation API endpoints in the browser and revealed my real location. Another important parameter are languages, which you also should consider when changing an IP address and hence your location. There's actually many other methods that websites can deploy in order to detect proxies. They also include port scanning and also scanning for headers. By the way, in multi-login, all these parameters are masked in accordance with your proxy. So if you're using a proxy or you're changing an IP address through other means, multi-login browser profile will automatically match the browser fingerprints with the information of your IP address. So how can you choose the right proxy for yourself? First of all, you should know that residential or mobile IPs are currently the best, simply because it is very difficult to block these IP ranges because they are coming from real pool of users. Data center proxies may also work. Don't think that they are totally bad. However, you have to ensure that you have a data center proxy provider that provides exclusive IP addresses for you, because data center proxies are really not a normal behavior in the web. Websites can easily block these data center IPs, and hence, if you get an IP address that has been used in a bad ways before, your accounts will be in jeopardy. By the way, you can check for different proxy recommendations on our website, multilogin.com/proxy. Over there, you can find different categories of proxies, starting from residential, mobile, and data center. I do have to point out that right now, mobile proxies are becoming the winners, simply because it's very difficult to block a mobile IP address. As I said before, there's a technology called NAT that basically makes it so that many different users that are using mobile internet may have the same IP address at the same time. I currently have a mobile IP on my phone right here, right now, and there might be over 3 to 5 or even 10 different people with different phones that will have the same IP address. And imagine the website will not be really incentivized to block this IP address, simply because other users can also get blocked. Hence, websites do not really want to block mobile IP addresses. By the way, residential and mobile IPs can be quite expensive. So if you're just starting out, out, there is a very cheap method how you can create your own mobile proxy using an Android device. You can find instructions on how to do this on our channel. This method is very easy to set up and it will provide you with high quality mobile IP addresses to run your multiple accounts with very, very low risk of getting restricted. And that is it. That's the theory behind how websites can use IP addresses to detect you and block you. This is how websites can detect proxies. I hope this was useful to you. Don't forget to educate yourself in this field because knowledge is the key. If you know how these systems work, then you can properly combat them and work with them. Thanks very much for watching. If you're interested in this type of content, make sure that you click that subscribe button, as YouTubers say. And don't forget to subscribe to our Telegram channel and Twitter channel, where we also post information about these types of videos. Thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you in other videos. Bye bye.